Gustavo Yokota, it's been, shall we say, a long day or a long afternoon and evening. I see you started round about 1 o'clock. We've got to now to about 7 p.m. You've never stopped playing. 3 matches cadet boys singles, 3 matches junior boys singles, and 2 cadet boys doubles. Now, right now, tell me, how are you feeling?
I'm very tired, of course, because I was not expecting to play consecutive matches like this with a break of 5 minutes, 10 minutes of each one, so I'm very tired.
Well, I'm not surprised. It's been nearly an impossible day for you, but just ended a little bit on a sad note for you. You lost in the quarterfinals of the junior boys singles to firm Intenti of Argentina. Now, he's the number 2 seed, yeah, he's expected to win, but what was difficult for you there?
I think he was very prepared and he was stronger than me in his mind and I think also in his body, you know, he was not so tired like me and he's also more experienced than me. He's better, I know that he's better, but
Well, of course, you know, his days of cadet table tennis are over. He only had to play the junior boys singles and junior boys doubles. He didn't have the extra matches. But, of course, let's go to happier times. Round one, you beat Brian Afanado of Puerto Rico. You beat him 4-2. He's the number 3 seed and he's the Latin American junior boys champion. Now, that win must absolutely delight you.
Yes, I'm very happy with these results. I think that I played good with him today, you know, I was better than the normal, I think. And I played with him already 2 times last year, so I know him and I think that I was prepared for this match.
Now you say you played him twice last year, how did you get on last year?
I beat him the last in the quarterfinals of Mexico Junior Circuit, 3-2, but always a hard match.
Well, it was a tough match, didn't it? It was a delight to watch. Of course, the one thing we have to mention about your play is you're a defensive player, the modern-day defender, with the forehand topspin. Now, what prompted that style of play? Because for South American players, okay, I know there's Li Hu from Dominican Republic, but of course he hails from China. But what prompted you to go with this style?
I think that my coach was very important in this point because he saw in me potential to be a defensive player, so it was very important that he told me to try and I like it.
Well, you play very well with that style and the coach is Francisco Arado, I believe, who I met first of all in 1996 in the Men's World Cup in Lima, a fine player himself. But what about the materials that you're using? Obviously you're using the reverse rubber on the forehand, but what about the backhand?
In the backhand I use long pimples from TSP and it's that, I think that...
Is there any reason why you choose the long pimples as opposed to the short pimples? Because certainly many of the Chinese defenders, Guo Ying Chao especially, he uses the short, take the Korean George Hill, he will use the long, so is there a reason for the choice?
It was also my coach that told me that it would be better with long pimples because it's more easy to learn and it's more comfortable. So he helped me in everything, I think.
Well, it gives you a safe side as well, doesn't it? And of course, we should mention you're the number 1 seed in the cadet boys singles event and you're through to the semi-final. So in the cadet event, you must be pleased with your performance today.
Yes, I'm very happy with today, like in everything. I think that I was good. Of course, in the last match, I was very tired, but I think that I'm prepared to play good in cadet and also surprise in junior.
Well, I mean, tremendous performance, and let's just get this right. I think, according to my mathematics, it was something like 8 matches, one after each other, in the space of little over 6 hours. So we wish you a good night's sleep, and today a tremendous performance throughout the tournament from Brazil's Gustavo Yokota.